Hello viewers, welcome back to my channel. Today's topic is main bar and distribution bar in slabs. When we look at any reinforcement detailing, we are able to see there may be two sizes of bars used in the slab. We know that is main reinforcement bar and distribution reinforcement bar. But wait, there is more than just the name. Let's discuss. We have studied that the load act on the slab will be high at the center of the slab as shown in the figure. Let's take an example. Place a thin plastic pad at the support of four ends. Now give pressure with your finger at the top of the pad. You see the deflection under the bottom center of the pad and a rise at the top of the support as shown in the above figure. What actually happens is the bottom of pad experiences a sagging moment and the supports experience a hugging moment. The bottom of the slab at center and the top of the slab at supports experience high tension at the same time. You may see the deflection high in the shorter span and low in longer span. The support which is very near experience high tension than the far one. Let's see function of main reinforcement bars. In order to transfer that bending moment developed at the bottom of the slab, main reinforcement bar is to provide at the shorter span direction. The purpose of the main bar is to transfer the bending load developed at the bottom of the slab to the beams. That's why we place main reinforcement bars at the bottom of the slab. Also use slightly stronger dimension bars, and we place main bars at the shorter span. The function of distribution bars. On the other hand, distribution bars are used to resist the shear stress cracks developed in the longer span. That's why we place the distribution bar perpendicularly on top of the main bars, and we use lesser dimension bars, we place them at the longer span.